Hello and welcome, fellow YouTubers. My name is Draconis Windrunner, and today I'm going to be doing a Let's Play of Dark Souls. And in this series, I'm going to let you, the viewer, decide what way I'm going to go. We'll stop at pivotal moments, and I'll let you pick which bosses I go after next. I'm going to pick the Thief. I'm partial to the dexterity builds myself. It's going to make it a lot easier for me. Other than that, I'm just going to pretty much give him basics. And here we go. You may hear commentary from the kids. Please ignore that if you can. Other than that, I'll try to make this as painless as possible. How many times I died at this first boss. Like, when I started playing this game, I was such a noob. Probably 10, 15 times in this room before I realized, oh my god, there's actually a door over here.
An est.
The silent demon here is quite simple, as long as you remember to actually drop down and attack. But if you stand up here long enough, he will eventually just jump up here and smash this ledge, and he'll take you with it. So there is an item up here to the left. It's just a soul item, but if you don't know it's here, you'll miss it multiple times, especially when you go through the first time or you come back on your revisit. Over here on the right, just the crow snuggle, you can drop items at them. Make sure that it's actually in the nest, otherwise when you quit and reload, the item will just disappear instead of change to the new item that they give you. But we are here at Fire Link, the first of our turning points. I can either go up to the Undead Burg, and I can go after the Taros Demon and continue that way on to the first bell, or I can go down, and since I do have the Master Key as a Thief, I can get into the swamps, and I can go after Quelaag. I'm gonna stop it here and let you guys decide which way to go. As always, if you like the video, like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you in the next recording.